Mungano was the people's movement that started over the issues of threats of evictions and land grabbing. So there were a lot of communities, slums, that got threats for evictions, and they got notices. A lot of the rich would go to the community and they would grab land. So out of that, Mungano was born. We, for solidarity purposes, they started, when this community is threatened, we would meet together with the other communities for solidarity and mainly to strategize on what to do. The Land Caucus was the arm that was supporting Mungano in terms of the actions that they can take. For example, the legal representation. Because we used to use legal and non-legal means to protect the community. The legal would be to have a case in court and which Kitucha Sheria was the active partner there. Then we used to strategize demonstrations, protests over the community. And the Land Caucus provided the CEOs, the community organizers, that would make sure that we organize actions at the local. So that's how we got community organizer organizing. And the meetings became many. And at the same time, we started now with the resistance. We realized that we might get in trouble with people fighting back, you know, fighting the police, fighting the ghouls. At that time, at the Land Caucus, we thought about active nonviolence, and so that we train people to resist in the evictions in active nonviolence, so that we don't use violence, so that we don't have damages, we don't have people dying, you know. So at the Land Caucus, we discussed one evening, and we got contacts, and we got people from I think from US who came to train on active nonviolence. The idea is to do the resistance without causing violence. We were able to get contacts, organized for a training, and some of us were trained on active nonviolence, and the movement started. So we started training, they started a new movement of Chemichemi Okweli that was now specializing on training on nonviolence, and we trained communities also on active nonviolence because the resistance was becoming more violent each time. At the same time, during that time, we were trained on issue-based organizing. But the movement, there came new development. We got to be introduced to these other methods of savings, organizing through the savings. And that is how we had the people from India, from South Africa, coming in. At the same time, during that period, Pamoja Trust was formed. Specifically, because now Kitucha Sheria had been overwhelmed by these cases, and they had started a program to outreach program, which became bigger than the legal department. And the board thought that the Kituo was going out of the initial need, so they wanted to, because the outreach program had grown than the legal one. Now, they tend, and that's how we thought of forming an organization that will support Mungano directly, and that organization is Pamoja Trust.